Okay guys, today finally my phone got a major Android Auto update that everybody was asking me for a year now. And now I have a full screen Android Auto that fits any car. It uses different cards to fill the entire screen. So let's go and show you how it looks. First, I'll demo this new Android Auto feature on this 2022 Mercedes C-Class, because it has such an unusual screen size. So let's open the door, and as you can see, this screen has a very unique square shape. And as soon as I connected my cell phone via this Android Auto app, bam! You can see that Android Auto filled the entire screen using multiple split-screen windows. The top portion of the screen is naturally filled with the Google Maps app for navigation. You can move it, zoom in and out, and enter any destination address as usual. But what's new is you have multiple windows containing different apps that you can control on the same screen. So, for example, I have this YouTube music app on the same screen as the navigation. Now I can change the music track without leaving the navigation. And since there is enough space, I also got the weather app. Very cool. Each window can be controlled inside independently from the other. If you click the button on the bottom left, you can easily select another app you installed and replace it with the current one on your main screen. Let's select Google News, for example, and pick any source.
Hello from CNN. I'm Anna Sterla with the 5 things you need to know for Thursday, February 16th.
Now, if we go back to our main screen, we can see that this Google News app replaced the YouTube Music app. Additionally, on the bottom, you have direct shortcuts to the apps that you use the most. Let me show you another example, and let's replace Google News with, let's say, Spotify Music. And let's select one of these playlists. It doesn't matter, let's say this one. And as you can see, Spotify plays Bon Jovi on the main screen, replacing Google News. You can click the Google Maps button to view it in full screen. Then click the same button again to view and control all 3 apps.
And before we continue, I would really appreciate if you could click a like button below this video, because that's the only way I can promote this channel.
One thing I found disappointing was when I tried this new version of Android Auto on the 2020 Mercedes GLS class, equipped with the MBUX system, this app still doesn't cover the entire 12.5-inch screen and still has a 16:9 display resolution. However, it does offer multi-windows now, so you can control different apps on the same screen, which is nice. And all the shortcuts are on the left side. When you touch one window, it goes full screen. I highly recommend going into the settings and turning the traffic on Google Maps. That way you can see the traffic highlighted in red, so you can proactively avoid it. Also, I recommend switching on the satellite view, so you can see the actual streets, houses, and surroundings. You can move the map on the screen and zoom in and out to see everything up close. Or hit the recenter button to go back to a bird's eye view. But now these multi-window buttons let you control different apps on the split screen. Or you can go into a full screen by touching the window. You can also split the screen with the third window, showing the recent destinations and the time to get there. You can also reduce the number of open windows or replace the app for the front screen.
For example, let's select a podcast app. And pick this podcast as an example. And now, when I switch to navigation, the podcast will play in the background. Or you can split the screen to control them both. But unfortunately, this update version of Android Auto still covers only part of the screen. And you can still see the black gaps on the sides. And one of the reasons it cannot cover the whole screen is because it doesn't want to interfere with Mercedes climate controls. As you can see the temperature on both sides, as well as Mercedes text notifications and the Mercedes home button. So now while using the Android Auto app, you can click the Mercedes home button and exit to your original dashboard. Or click the Android Auto tab and go back. If you want to see a full tutorial on how to use Android Auto, watch my other video, which I demoed on a different car, but it works the same in any vehicle. This video became very popular recently and already has over 300,000 views. The link is below this video in the description area. And the question of today is, what do you use in your car? Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, or just the original car navigation? Please let us know in the comment section below.